is Jen and welcome back to my channel. I am back with a new hairdo. I did go for the chop. This time I decided to go for a little below the shoulder so that I can dye the ends of my hair and just play around with the color at the ends and then just chop it off if it gets really damaged. It feels so good to have short hair, honestly. I just felt like a change and the ends of my hair was really damaged. So I just wanted to cut that all off one day and I was like, I need soft hair back in my life. It's super soft and I'm loving it. But yes, for this video, I have a couple of updates for you guys. Firstly, for my monthly favorites, I am going to be doing this on a monthly basis on the last week of every month. Whereas in the past, it used to be every 2 to 3 months where I catch you guys up in like a huge long video. And I've also decided to not just talk about makeup and skincare items that I've been loving, but also two more segments where I'll be talking about my fashion favorites, my outfit items that I've been loving that month. And thirdly, my monthly musings. I don't just want to talk about beauty, but also about things that I've been thinking about, some things that I've been learning, maybe life lessons or a quote that's been really dear to my heart that month. So yes, I hope you guys are looking forward to that. And I'm going to also be having regular videos on the first, second and third weeks of the month too. So don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Thumbs up this video if you are excited and you are loving my new hair, because I know I am. Okay, so let us begin without further ado with this September favorite. So this first item is actually an empty and it is the SK-II facial treatment essence. Don't worry, this is not sponsored. There's nothing like that going on here. You guys know I've been actually using this since I first started my YouTube, which is 6.5 years ago. This is seriously the one skincare item that I cannot go without every morning and every night. What I love about it is that it preps my skin for the next skincare products. It also helps to absorb in the moisture and hydration and it keeps my skin feeling and looking smoother, even toned, and just in general brighter and not as dull and dead. One way that I've been really loving using this product this month is soaking some cotton pads, you know, the thin ones which you can peel the layers apart. I just soak about 2 or 3 cotton pads full of this and place it over my face, my cheeks, and my forehead. Leave it on for like 10-15 minutes like a face mask, and seriously, my skin just feels super plumped and hydrated and moist from inside. It just feels firmer and looks so glowing and healthy the next day. Now, another ultimate holy grail for me, which I have talked about since the beginning of my YouTube days, is this L'Occitane 20% Shea Butter Hand Cream. This is for dry skin and it is so used and battered and tattered and the label is falling off. I even have a backup with a new size because that's how much I love it. I started using this hand cream since my 21st birthday, where I received it as a birthday present and I got hooked on it. It's thick enough to really even help the cuticle areas, but it's not greasy and it doesn't just sit as a layer on the skin, transferring onto everything you touch. But it's also thin enough to absorb really well and really hydrate without feeling like it's just sitting on the skin. My holy grail hand cream. Now moving on to sunscreen, the La Roche-Posay Superior Daily Protection Aqua Fresh Gel. In Korean, it says Aqua Sun Fluid. It has SPF 50 PA Quadruple Plus. It is a very hygienic pump bottle and it's a really nice light gel consistency, which doesn't feel like a sunscreen at all. And it doesn't leave the skin super oily and greasy or feeling heavy. It's actually really nice under makeup. So I've been really liking this sunscreen. It's suitable for sensitive skin and it's also fragrance free, which I love. My favorite foundation for this month has to be the Dior Forever Foundation. Perfect makeup, everlasting wear, pore refining effect. It's got SPF 35 PA Triple Plus, which is pretty good for a foundation, and it's got shine control. So this is not a super matte or super dewy foundation. It's like really right in the middle. It's very porcelain, satiny. I've got dry skin around my nose area and then I've got an oily T-zone. So I've got like all four seasons on my face and this never patches up around there and it never oils up around my forehead. It lasts quite a long time. Very nice medium coverage. It sits nicely on the skin and fills in the pores, and it's also got sunscreen as well. So I highly recommend this if you're looking for a new foundation. The next one is kind of random, but it still is a beauty favorite, so I did want to mention it. And I'm not sure how accessible it is outside of Korea, but I thought I'd give it a shot anyway. It is the Wet Brush Pro. It looks like a standard brush, but it's actually a brush that you can use straight out of the shower without causing any damage or snagging anywhere. It can be really hard to style the hair straight out of the shower, and I do love to have the combed effect in order for it to dry nicer. But a lot of standard brushes can actually like sort of snag the hair hair. But this one goes in so smooth, like it literally goes through my hair like this when it's wet. I love that I can just do this without worrying that it's gonna pull my hair out or be bad for the hair. So I did want to mention this. In Korea, it's available at Olive Young stores. Susie sent me this Soap and Glory Archery eyebrow product, which I said in the video I've used in the past before and I loved it. I've actually been using this every single day since I've opened that box. My one is in brownie points and it's the perfect shade for me. It's like an ash medium brown color. It's got like a little bit of wax in the formula as well so that it kind of grips your hairs and makes it look really nice and neat. Highly recommend you guys to check it out. I'm pretty sure it would be a little bit cheaper than the Anastasia brow pencils, I think. Don't quote me on that, but go check it out if you guys can access this because this brow pencil is amazing. For mascara, I have been absolutely loving this Korean drugstore version mascara, which a lot of people love already, but I wanted to mention it because I've been using it every single day. And it's the Etude House Curl Fix Mascara. It's the version that has this sort of semi-rounded edge with a straight edge on the other side. It has a waterproof formula, absolutely holds the curl in place, and it coats and really dramatizes the lashes so much to the point that it looks like your lashes are almost fake. These days, instead of using a full false lash, I've been loving my individual lashes. And the ones that I've been recently loving are from The Face Shop. This is the Pro Eyelashes Point Picks. It's a Korean roadshop brand. So what I do is I take about two or three of these and I place it on the outer half of my eyes. I take a little bit of lash glue and I dot it exactly where I want it to go and I just place it right there. Literally everyone is always like, have you got false lashes on or are they your natural lashes? I mean, it looks so natural, but it enlarges the eyes and it's not like I've tried so hard to look good today kind of thing. Now, I don't know if you guys can see today, but I've got a little bit of sparkle under the eyes. What I've been loving for the Aegyotire, for the glitter component of makeup, has been the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Eyeliner. This one is in Distortion and I went through so much trouble trying to find this shade. It's this beautiful multi-colored reflex with a sort of holographic finish to it. And I do notice that the color sort of changes depending on the lighting, which is beautiful. Adds this extra oomph, especially for nighttime occasions. It also doesn't just disappear throughout the day. It actually stays put. I've been really loving that. Now, I love brushes and I love to keep them clean, but obviously no one has the time to deep cleanse them all the time. So for spot cleaning, this is something I've been absolutely loving. It's a Too Cool for School Art Class Brush Cleanser Mist that you use for spot cleaning. So whenever my brush gets a little bit dirty and I don't have time to go wash it, I just spritz a little bit of this on the brush onto a paper towel and then I just rub it and it completely cleans it really nicely with hardly any smell to it. It just feels very, very gentle and does a really great job. So I've been loving having this on my vanity for quick touch-ups for my brushes. And I can't go without my favorite lip combination for this month. And what I've been using on my lips the past month were these four products here. So my first step is to apply Benefit's Cha-Cha Tint as a general wash over the lips. And then I apply the 3CE Style Nanda Water Tint on the inner part of the lips. And this one is in magenta red. And then I use the Jeongsaemul lipstick in Lip Lure. So it's actually her lipstick line, but she did make a concealer version. It's very matte, but it's not completely drying. So it does leave the lips looking nice. So I use this to just dot the edges of my lip and then just give it a little bit of a smudge with my fingers. And then because gradient lips don't look nice when it's matte, I really love to top it off with a bit of lip gloss. And what I've been using for that is the Majolica Majorca lip gloss. And this is in PK102. It's a more translucent-y type of lip gloss. And this is what I've got on my lips today. So that's been my absolute favorite lip combination. And onto my final favorites for beauty, it is my contact lenses. I've been going through a period of my life where I've been loving and appreciating my natural irises and my natural color. But the past month, I've been dappling back into natural colored contacts. And the ones that I've been loving this month is from this Korean one, the Color Ample Silks in Giselle, and it's 14 millimeters in diameter. So I've got them on today. You can probably not tell at all. That's why I love it so much. It's so natural and it just slightly, ever so slightly, widens your pupils without looking like circle lenses. And it adds a slight depth to the eyes, but it's most importantly so comfortable. Literally, this is the most comfortable contact lenses that I've ever used. I'm not even kidding right now. It's so comfortable. So yes, I finally included one of my favorite Korean contact lenses in my favorites video. So many of you guys have been asking for it. Now onto fashion favorite items. This is my first time ever doing a segment for this. I'm so excited. So many of you guys ask me what do I wear on a regular basis. So the past month, I've been absolutely obsessed with navy. Navy has just been my entire wardrobe, basically. The three favorite blue tops that I've been absolutely wearing the heck out of this month have been these three. The first one is this American Eagle Outfitters, which I wore in one of my recent videos as well. This is a shoulderless top. And it's so pretty. I love the little details. I love how comfortable it is. It's a little bit ruffly, but not like too noticeably. And it's got these beautiful details here, which just looks so nice. It kind of has this flirty look. It's kind of sexy as well. It's so cute. I've been loving this top so much. And then these two tops are actually from H&M, so they're really affordable, but they're all also navy versions. I wore this to an SK2 event with my Armani pants, and it looked so expensive. I'm not sure if you can tell in the video, but it has like this area here, which is lace, and you can see through just up to about here. So it's got really nice details, honestly, and it's so comfortable, and it just looks really casual yet sophisticated and classy, and goes well with both skirts or pants. I have been wearing this literally all the time. And finally, this other H&M top. This one has like a V-neck. This one is polyester, but it looks a little bit like silk. The material just looks really expensive in real life. No one could tell that this is from H&M, honestly, when I'm wearing it. So I love it. This one is more for the formal occasions when I need to look more classy or if I'm going to a fancy location. I've been wearing the heck out of this as well with some tight pants and some heels. So that's for tops. And for pants, I recently bought a new pair of jeans from Ted Baker. I love black skinnies, but I just love the detail that went into this, the rose gold finish. Inside, there's a really nice patterning. And then what I absolutely love about these jeans are the ends. I don't know what to call it, but they've got these details and patterns at the ends, and it kind of sticks really nice and finishes just above the ankles. So it looks beautiful paired together with some really nice heels. And last but not least, for my outfit faves, I have been wearing either one of these two bags. So this is my Ferragamo little purse that William got for me a while ago. I love it. It's a crossbody bag. It's got this gold chain, a metallic closure, and a little pouch inside as well. It fits my makeup, it fits my purse, and it fits my phone, which is everything I need. So I literally wear this all the time, and you can see my wear and tear going onto that. If I'm looking a little bit more girly with my outfit and I'm going to a formal place, I've been loving my Miu Miu bag. I'm not sure if you guys remember this, but William got this for me for my 21st birthday. 21st or 22nd? And it still looks good as new. What I love about designer bags, that they just last you for so long. It's a dusty pink color, and it fits just about everything I need. It's got my phone and wallet in there. I have to say, I've been wearing this a lot more in Korea than when I was in Australia. I'm not sure why, it just kind of like suits this country a little bit better. But yeah, I've been rocking this baby and loving it so much in Korea, so. Okay, so now onto my first ever monthly musings. Some musings that I've been thinking about this month have been world affairs. One thing I've been really feeling like is that we are entering this new era of the world. Everything just feels very different to me, and I'm not sure what exactly it is, but there's so many things happening around the world. It's becoming a very political environment everywhere you live, and I feel like it's just beyond any kind of era that I've ever lived in my life. At the same time, it is very exciting. We don't know what's ahead, but that's just something that I've been feeling, and I'm not sure about you guys. It might just be me, but it definitely feels a little bit different. And life feels slightly more serious to me. I'm not sure exactly why, but there are a lot of things that I'm praying for and keeping in mind, especially the victims of the hurricanes and all of the natural disasters. There's just been so many, and I can't believe that it's been happening in such a short time. So if anyone out there that's watching has been affected or knows anyone that's affected, please know that I send my heart and my sincere prayers out to you, and hope that everyone is doing okay. So that's one thing. And then in regards to Korea, a lot of you guys have actually been asking me if everything's okay here with all of the North Korean debacle. One thing I do know for sure is that the Western media is really pumping out that North Korea, South Korea tension thing a lot more than we feel it here in Korea. And I guess we'll never know the exact truth, since media can be so distorting. Here in Korea, honestly, the climate here is actually pretty much the same. No one's feeling tense about anything. I mean, literally South Korea and North Korea never finished their war ever since decades ago. It's been ongoing, so it's never actually been finished. So literally North Korea has been on the news every day in Korea for decades. I mean, if something does happen, that is how it's meant to play out, but everyone's just going ahead with their lives and still enjoying it. So that's what the climate is like over here in Korea. And I just wanted to update you guys that William and I are doing okay. Thirdly is a little life lesson. Something that I have really been learning is how to say no. I'm always someone who's been quite open and kind of like taking on every opportunity as it comes. But this month, I've been learning that sometimes you really do have to say no. Honestly, my life, the place I am at now, I feel like I have a limited amount of time and energy. And if it's something that I really don't believe in or don't feel peace about, I've been learning to say no. And knowing that it's okay to do that because our lives are really precious, so it's really important, I believe, what you choose to take on and what you don't choose to take on. And for me, my beliefs and my stance and my morals are a lot higher on my priority list than, you know, somehow just getting ahead with opportunities or even meeting people. Because if you're burnt out, that's good for no one. And being able to take on the right projects and give my everything and put my passion into it because I know that's something that's really worth my time and heart. So yeah, that's just something that I've been learning. I would love to hear what you guys have recently been learning and feeling about this world or about your life. Please do share it with all of our Musa fam down in the comments below. We'd love to hear it. And also, what is your favorite item that you've been loving this month? Let us know in the comments below. So that concludes the end of this favorites video. I hope you guys enjoyed this new take on my monthly favorites. And I hope you guys have a really lovely, lovely, wonderful week. Until my next video, stay beautiful inside and out. And don't forget, I love you guys heaps and heaps. I'll see you guys in my next video.